Hello, everyone. I'm here to show you a new feature under Atlas.ti, which is the AI auto transcription. So this means that you can upload your audio and video file into the system, and then you can ask it to transcribe it for you. If you want to get transcription credit, you can just go to their website. I'm going to post the link down for you to get access to it in case you want to have the transcription. So you can go to their website and then click on buy transcription credit. So if you want 2 hours, you can buy it for $19. You can choose the one that you think will help you to transcribe all of your audios and videos. This kind of auto transcription only works for the desktop version. So it cannot work when you have the online version, the web version, right? It only works on the desktop version of Atlas.ti. So I'm going to really show you how to transcribe your audio within Atlas.ti. And if you buy the desktop version, you get 60 minutes free credit for you to transcribe your audio and video. And if it's not enough, then you can go ahead and buy the hours that you need for your transcription. So let's go to Atlas.ti and show you how it's done. So now you can see my project here. I've already uploaded my transcripts. So imagine that I have an audio or video that I have not transcribed yet, and I want to bring it into Atlas.ti. How do you do that? When you are ready, you go to Atlas.ti and then click on Add Documents, and then you can click on Add Link Video or Audio, right? And then this time we look for the video or audio that you want to import and transcribe. You click on open and then you go to transcribe. Click on transcribe. You have option here. You can choose from any of these languages, or you want the system to auto detect the kind of language that is in the audio or the video. At this point, I just leave this part alone. Or you can, if you want a system to transcribe it in English or any other language, or you want to tell the system the kind of language the audio is in, you can check that. Right now, you can leave this place as auto detect. If you want the system to indicate the speakers, right, especially you did an interview and you want to separate what you said from what participants said, it's good to choose this one. And if you want the system to code the speakers for you too, you can also check that one, right? So this means that it will create containers and put what each of the speakers said in those containers, right? If you want a system to remove filter words like am or are, you can check this one. Normally, I don't want to remove filter words because it can also help you to better understand what participants were saying. Here it tells you the amount of credit that you have in terms of transcription. You see here that I have 5 hours, 43 minutes, right, of transcription. And here it's also indicating the length of the information that you have uploaded. Here, the length is 10 minutes, 39 seconds, right? When you are okay with everything here, you click on transcribe. And it doesn't take time. Sometimes it depends on the length of the transcript. So let's wait and see what we're going to get. So now I can see here that the system has been able to transcribe everything for me. So it has divided into speaker one and speaker two. This document was a podcast related to mental health, right? So there were two speakers. So that's why you can see the speaker one and speaker two. So in your case, if it was an interview, you might be the speaker one, right? And then the participant will be speaker two. So it's good that the system has separated it for you so that you know what you said and also what participants said. And then as you can see here, the system has coded them for you. This means that the system has grouped or create containers for each of the speakers and put all the information there. If you want to know, you go under code, you see here transcript speakers. And then when you click on this arrow, you can see speaker one information here, speaker two. If you want to know what speaker one said, you can double click and see all that speaker one said. You can also code from here. You can select that information and then you can go to apply code and do the coding there if you want to code this information. You can also change the name right? You can also rename the speaker. How do you do that? You can right click on it and go to rename. And then if you want to change it to maybe interviewer, you can change it to interviewer. And when you change, you can see here that everything has changed. You can also right click here and go to rename and change it to participant. Maybe P1, right? Or maybe it's P14, participant P14 or P14. You just put a label for the participant there and then click on rename and then it changes to P14. So you easily see who said what. So that's why I like when you choose coding. When we're going through the process, I indicate coding so the system will code and then you'll be able to change the name so that you know that, okay, this is what I said, and it is what the participant said. So that the coding will be very easy for you. When you want to see the document, the transcript is here. So you can double click on the transcript here. And when you double click, this is what you're going to see. It is already here, but let's close this one and double click and then show you. So you already have, double clicking so you can start the coding process. If you want to know how to do the coding, I have a lot of videos there about how to code. I will put one either here or here for you to see and click on it. So this is just a brief information about how to upload audio or video and then start a coding process. Another thing that you may have to know that is that one thing I like about this function is you can play and listen to participant as you do the coding, right?
We're going to unpack this research paper you shared about what mental health service users really need, and it's pretty eye-opening stuff. Imagine like going to the doctor for something, a physical problem, and they just won't tell you what's wrong or like how the treatment's supposed to work.
It's a dreadful thought, isn't it? And yet, that feeling of being left in the dark is something that a lot of mental health services.
So you see that you can listen to participant responses and then you can see the areas. And it's so interesting that as you are listening, you can do the coding. So let's say you are listening and then you got here and you realize that it's very important information. You can right click and go to apply code and type the code that you want to it to represent. And then, so if this one is concerned about mental health stigma, right? And then if that's what it is, what it's representing, you just click on the plus and then you do the coding. Or you can go to apply codes and then you can type what code that you want to do. Or you can go to all codes and then you can decide where you want to put this information. If you want to put it here, you can click on this one and then it's coded to that, right? You can also click on suggested. The system will suggest a code for you. And if you think that is the relevant to the significant information, you can do the code there. If you want to know more, I have a video about coding using Atlas.ti. You'll be able to get more information. But I think this one makes your work so easy for you. You have your audio, you bring the audio there, you can listen to the audio as you are going through your transcript. And then you'll be able to code at the same time. You have the audio there, you have the transcript here, you can play at the same time going through, and you'll be able to easily code. So that's what I like, unique thing I like about this function. So, and you can also auto code. I have videos about how to automatically code your data using AI within Atlas.ti. So this is what I have for you. As I indicated, this function is only available for the desktop. And if you want to buy this software, I have a promo code in my description there. You can choose, I have a promo code in the description. You can use the promo code and then get a very good discount. I think it's about 20% discount. So, and also when you get access to it, you get a free 1 hour transcription to use, right? And then if it's not enough, then you can go back to the website and get more. And I'll put the link there. When you click here, buy, you'll be able to get access to the place that you can buy additional credit for your transcription. I hope this one was helpful. If you have any question, put it in the comment section and I'll be happy to address them for you. Thank you so much for your time.